Most likely knowledge, Steve Rule, he's the CEO for the Cox Division Center, Catherine Thomas, Vice President Wilson, and the head of the 9/11 dispatch, Alex Lowe. I'll be done in 1 second. I just want to acknowledge and say good morning to Mr. Mayor. He says it's like it's bar mitzvah. This is a mitzvah. What you just did for this community and for the Thai community. We service the Muslim community, the Italian community. We're non-sectarian. But by helping us and your city agencies getting this piece of property, we have to go through 20 public hearings. Everything was done above board. But still, from the bottom of my heart, and from 12,000 people that we saved this year, just in Boro Park, I want to say thank you very much. It's a big mitzvah, and I want to wish you a lot of luck in all your future endeavors. Thank you for listening to me, for God's help, for the short time that you make a commitment to buy here. Thank you.
No organization like Hatzolah. There's no organization like Hatzolah. Everybody has had, unfortunately or fortunately, experiences with Hatzolah in their own homes, other places. My father, many years ago, was having a heart attack, only one of many incidents. And my mother picked up the phone and called Hatzolah. And before she hung up the phone, a certain volunteer was in my mother's kitchen attending to my father. That volunteer happens to be one of the coordinators, Laser Rosman. But just the council members for Pork Barrel or Burger Barrel, they do not come to any elected officials. Everyone in government wants to give Hatzolah money to be able to be a part of it and, of course, then take credit for it. They don't take any government money. So it's a testament to this great mayor. He figured out a way how to help Hatzolah against their will by getting them this lot. And he may wind up being the only elected official in history, at least for a long time, to have done so. So it gives me great pleasure to be here today. I would just ask all the Hatzolah members to please stand up. I'm not going to leave until you do it. I'd like to ask all the Hatzolah volunteers to stand up. All right, come on. One minute.
Picking up where we left off in 2005. Now, in 2005, many of you were here today, right at this place, where the city agreed to sell this long vacant lot to Hatzolah for the Boro Park future home. Now, here we are, 3 years later. Now, I know what you're all saying. Why did it take 3 years to go from then to now? After all, Noah built the ark in less time than that. Ah, but Noah didn't have to file an environmental impact statement. Made it a lot easier. Seriously, today is cause for a Simcha in every sense of the word. And of course, that includes Simcha Felder, our city council member. You should know that Simcha worked on this project 24/6. Thought that would have gotten a better laugh than that. So Simcha, that'll help you keep up your strength. And it also has my mother's phone number when you need some encouragement and support in this. So this is for you, Simcha. Simcha, I could do some translation for you, but Simcha also translates to rejoicing. Do you ever rejoice, relax, have a good time,
only when
kid around?
You.
Thank you very much. Seriously, this is a great day for rejoicing in Boro Park. Devotion to the sick and needy, and that's really woven so tightly into this community. And it's one sign of the support that Hatzolah has already raised $2 million out of the $5 million needed to build this headquarters. Now, where's the other $3 million coming from? You didn't think this was a fundraising call? Why? Come on. This is on schedule to open in 2009. Our administration seriously was happy to do what we could. And I must give some credit to our former Community Assistance Unit Commissioner, Jonathan Greenspun, who really did work very hard. Hatzolah is nationally acclaimed, and it's their quick service and their scholarship and their abilities to really look at the patient, understand what the patient needs, distinguishes them as an ambulance service. This will give them two garages, this new one that we're going to build here and the existing garage on 16th Avenue. And by having two garages, they will be able to improve response time even more. And they'll also have facilities to train their staff, and that is very important. As technology gets better, you really want the people showing up to be the most trained, the most knowledgeable they possibly can be. And the fact is, Hatzolah is not just an emergency medical service. It embodies a 4,000-year-old commitment to relieve suffering and preserve human life. And this new facility seriously will help them do that. So I just wish for all of you, you never need Hatzolah, but it is great to know that if you do, they are there. And that really is a great comfort to all of us. So mazel tov. It's a wonderful day for New York.
How are you? Good, very good, thank you.
Okay.
All right.
Okay, guys, look over here.
Have a smile again, Mr. Mayor, for a second.
Time out. Everybody look to the right.
Okay, here we go.
Look to the right. Now look to the middle. Now look to the left. Okay, now on three, we're going to shove, throw the dirt, okay?
All right.
Starting with zero. Zero. We'll do this twice for the camera. Zero. One, two, three.
Hustle talk.
Okay, one more time. We're getting ready. Okay. On three. Zero. One, two, three.
Yay.
All right. We did it.
One more time.
It's enough of the hog labor.
Look at the camera.
Is the volume of the
Okay, she's. You haven't got the picture by now, you know. Okay.